Hey everybody, this is Captain Howdy from hookahpro.com, and today I've got a review for you for Othmani Turkish coffee. I haven't heard anything about this tobacco, so I don't know what to expect going into it. Othmani Star of Alhambra was a very good tobacco. Othmani Baklava, a little too sweet for me, but it was decent, but it wasn't baklava, we'll put it that way. So I'm not too sure what to expect of Turkish coffee. I haven't really found a decent coffee, I guess I should say. They're all just not coffee flavor, you know. You go in thinking, okay, this is gonna be coffee, and it's always, you know, hit or miss. It could be a little too sweet. It could taste like crap. You just never know. The cut on this was the Othmani cut that I had on Star of Alhambra. It's very fine, very sand-like. The smell on this, though, it's almost like a vanilla caramel frappuccino from Starbucks. I mean, I'm definitely picking up some vanilla notes in there. It kind of smells caramelish on the back end, but it's really sweet, just like a Starbucks coffee. It's not like a true coffee. You know how Starbucks puts about that much coffee in the rest of its cream? That's what this smells like to me. I'll be interested to see what it tastes like. I've got my Celsius Smoke Czar hookah set up here with a Vortex bowl, two Starlight Gnats, and a wing cover. I pulled on it about, I don't know, 2-3 minutes ago, and it wasn't ready, so let's see how it goes. Still not all that ready. Still got some tweaking to do with the Othmani. I haven't quite figured out the how long to let it sit and all the heat management issues with it. It seems to be very temperamental compared to something like Desi or Nacht. You know, those are, you just let it go and just go forever. What I did taste, though, I'm not too impressed with it. It is very, very sweet to me. And that was just a very small cloud on there. Let's see if I can pull some more. Still not big clouds yet, still heating up. Man, that is, it tastes like a frappuccino from Starbucks. The missus is giving me a good smile, so she's gonna like this one, I guarantee it. She loves the frappuccinos from Starbucks. I'm getting a big grin behind the camera right now, so she's gonna like this one. Starting to get there. It tastes just like it smells, which I'll give Othmani credit for that one. I mean, very rarely does it taste just like it smells. I can taste a vanilla, I can taste a hint of coffee, kind of a sweet caramel back into that. I don't know. I'm up in the air on this one. Maybe once it gets going, maybe the flavors will change. I don't know if I can recommend this one. Starting to get going now. Pull the wind cover off real quick before it starts to burn. It's a hot wind cover. Now it's starting to go a little bit. The sweetness is dying down. Just a bit. It's still overly sweet to me. And I like sweet coffee, I really do, but I do not... I'm up in the air. Try this one if you want, don't try it. That's up to you. I really can't give you a recommendation one way or the other, so Othmani Turkish coffee. So I decided to go ahead and do a part two on this. We are probably about 15-20 minutes into the session, and the sweetness has kind of gone down. Still not getting as big as clouds as I was yesterday with the Star of Alhambra, but the thing I do, like I said earlier, the sweetness has gone down quite a bit. I'm getting more of a caramel note. With a touch of sweetness. It's kind of a little, like the missus said while we were smoking, it's kind of salty. So it kind of reminded her of the fall flavor, one of those salted caramel frappuccinos or the salted caramel mochas that you get from Starbucks. It's kind of salty with a caramel mixed into it, and then you get the coffee note and a little bit of a sweet vanilla cream at the end of it. I don't know if I can still recommend this one. It's okay. It's a little sweet for me. Mrs. likes it. I'm still up in the air on it. I don't know. 50 grams, test it out. It's not that much. It's at least worth the taste. You may like it, you may not. I really couldn't tell you, so. Definitely pick up 50 grams of it. Let me know how it is. You may have better experience with it. It may just be the 50 grams. The 250 may be a lot better. I don't know. I don't think I could pick up 250 just based on this. But anyway, once again, this is Captain Howdy from hookahpro.com. Remember, Hookah Pro is your ultimate source for everything hookah. Thanks for watching.